Yo, let's go. 92 rated Kaká. He was released yesterday, and I'm hyped for these end of an era cars. If they continue releasing them like they did last year, we're going to have Torres, Xabi Alonso, maybe. But I didn't want to go too crazy and prepare to unlock every single one. Kaká, 92 overall, 100,000 coins with packs back. I didn't think it was that bad. I wanted to find out, though, if he's actually playable, or is it just one of those cars that is a little bit of a novelty? Poor stamina, his agility looks a little bit average, so we're gonna go find out today. So if you can drop a like, that'd be fantastic. If you are needing game codes or anything game related, head over to g2a.com, use the code FUJI on that site to get a discount on every single order, and let's head into it. So I was looking to build a past and present AC Milan team, but if I did it, I wanted to do it the right way and include Maldini, and unfortunately his loan card, because the prime icon hasn't been released yet, isn't available on the game, and I'm running very low on coins, and we've gone and purchased another guy for the RTG, Florenzi, 399k, last night his price range got adjusted to 800,000 coins bin, so he's been flooded, and his price is still 400k, 5 games, 5 goals, which is actually, I didn't even know he scored that many in this formation, 5 games, 5 goals as a right centre mid, impressive. I'll look at his stats in a second, but as we've gone with like an AC Milan theme, I've dropped in Ronaldinho alongside Shevchenko leading the attack, and then we have Kaká in that cam position. So one thing I like the look of with the Kaká card is that he's bringing height in that cam spot. 6'1", 4-star, 4-star, 5 games, 6 goals, 4 assists, which is nice. His pace on his card, if they're trying to make out like this is what his icon would be, or one of his icon cards, 85 pace just seems far too slow. He was rapid towards the end of his career, obviously he got slower, but he was very, very fast. I would give him like 90, 91 pace, maybe you'd think it's a little bit too fast. Let me know in the comments the pace that you would give the best version of Kaká, well, the fastest version. Let me know in the comments, it'd be interesting to see. Looking at his actual stats, acceleration-wise, sprint speed, it looks fine for a cam. Shooting, he's got all of that. Passing, brilliant. Dribbling-wise, when I saw him, when he got released, I was a bit worried because his balance is only 76. His agility, being 6'1", is only 81. And for the players that I've used recently, they've all got like 95, 99. So I was wondering if that would really affect my overall experience with the card. But the dribbling, the ball control, the composure should make up for that. And then what we need to bring up is the stamina. 55 stamina. Has it really affected the card to the point where he's useless? Like, no one really wants to go and purchase a player just to be using them as a super sub. Let's be real now. Unless you've already got like a main team and you don't mind bringing him on to have some fun with, but 100,000 coins to be spending on an actual super sub might be a little bit too much. So 88 strength is awesome, by the way, and I wasn't really expecting that because I saw 73 physical, looked at his actual stats in games, and 88 strength is awesome. So he can hold on to possession, he can power through, and that's what I was hoping from the card. So Florenzi's in-game stats, he's only got 3-star, 3-star, but then he has all of this stuff to make up for it. Like, attacking-wise, he's going to be powering down, well, down the line or through the middle because I'm using the narrow formation. Acceleration, sprint speed, that's what you look for. Just so much pace. His dribbling, he's got everything there. And his stand tackle, slide tackle, and interceptions is all pretty decent. And that 99 stamina with good aggression to help out his strength a little bit. And then I decided to drop in, well, Abate. I don't even know why I use him. Well, actually, I was looking to get chemistry with Florenzi, and I was only speaking about Abate a couple of days ago, suggesting that one of the overpowered players that everyone used to go for was Abate. You had Cordoba, if you're an OG on Ultimate Team, you'd remember him from the Serie A. Suazo, do you remember Suazo from Inter Milan? He was so broken, I loved him. Jonathan Tah, though, we had the guy on the account just because we packed him a couple of days ago, or was it last week? Can't remember when he was in form. 5 games with the card, and he's actually decent. I've got to be honest, I didn't feel that his pace was really letting him down at all. And his stand tackle and strength is remarkable. He was actually a good card, and for his price, I don't know how much he goes for, maybe like 20,000 coins. Very, very good. So that is a team exactly how I played it. I didn't go into a game, press start, switch anybody around. Kaká was the cam, and we're going to go find out if he's actually worth the coins. If you can drop a like, that'd be awesome. So what I'm about to say to you guys, I'm still in shock myself right now. And I was the one on Twitter suggesting with the crying face emojis that he was going to suck because of his poor stamina and poor agility. I was wrong. And sometimes you've just got to admit that. Don't get me wrong though, when you get to halftime and you look in the team management screen and you can see his stamina compared to others in your side, it is a lot lower. But in game, it doesn't really affect him that much, which is what I couldn't get my head around, because he was still going in the 85th minute, powering through, creating chances for other players and actually getting on the score sheet. Why is that? 55 is very, very low, and he was able to keep up with the pace of my team. And the reason why I say it like that, you know I'm a pace abuser, and I love just players that can just run continuously all throughout the game, and Kaká was playing very well in my side, and I would genuinely use him in the weekend league. 55 stamina, why hasn't it affected the card that much? Or is it just because I haven't really used players with that lower stamina? I don't know what it is, but I was really impressed. Acceleration-wise, good, and the sprint speed 83, I think it's a lot quicker than it suggests because of his height, 6'1", he gets into his stride very well and he can get past players. Added to the strength as well, powering his way through, dangerous card. Shooting wise, inside the box, left foot, right foot is going in the back of the net because of his 99 composure. And I've noticed this with Ronaldo. When I'm not even facing goal and I take a shot, they hit it on the swivel, and that's what Kaká was able to do for me. And I was trying the low driven finesse shots on the edge of the box. I've been scoring a few with Ronaldinho recently. Kaká didn't really have that much success with it, but if you're going to bang a shot from distance, just crack it across goal and it's going to find the back of the net. Kaká, finishing wise, very nice. Passing, you know he's going to be able to pass the ball. Dribbling, this is what I want to mention, because if you dribble a similar way to me and you do like to add in a few skills and just use the LTRT a little bit to set up dribbles, his agility doesn't feel that great, but it hasn't killed the card, because what this game is like revolved around is just the close control on the edge of the box. Turn one way, turn the other, turn one way, wait until your opponent commits to the challenge and then roll your man. And that's what Kaká is good at, because he has the 95 dribbling, the ball control, the composure, the reactions. Seriously impressed, and I'm actually pleased I unlocked him for 100,000 coins, because now when I do maybe a past and present AC Milan team after maybe this month, because after this month there's not really much to play for in the weekend league until, I'll still take it seriously, don't get it wrong, I'll wait until maybe team of the season and then we've got those kind of rewards. But Kaká, I want to get into a team with the likes of Maldini. Shevchenko was solid. Like, whenever I use Shevchenko, he's not really my kind of player, but he is the one to put the ball in the back of the net. Really impressed with him. But Kaká, seriously, if you're considering unlocking this card and you're worried about his stamina, try and ignore that. Trust me, ignore that. Don't think about it too much. Just play how you would play and he will keep up with your team. For me as well, like, I'm impressed. I do like Kaká and I'm a fan of him as well. I just wish that they gave him a little bit more pace. I know that he's not slow and he's actually pretty quick in game, but he should be a lot quicker. You know, in a cam position though, it's perfectly fine. Really, really good card. Florenzi, I want to speak about Florenzi a little bit more in the RTG episode tomorrow, but I picked him up for 400,000 coins and already he scored 5 goals in a centre mid position, and he is one of the perfect midfielders really in that 4-1-2-1-2, because he has like the pace of a winger, but he's actually a centre mid that can drop back and defend. So I can understand why he's that expensive. So anyway guys, that's where I'm going to end it. If you've got any questions about Kaká or the squad itself, let me know in the comment section. But players I'd recommend, actually Jonathan Tah was solid for his price. You've got Kaká that smashed it, Florenzi's pretty decent, but like I said, I'll speak about that in the RTG episode. So thanks ever so much for watching. Leave a like. Kaká is the OG AC Milan Kings. They played very well and I loved it. Thanks for watching. Team out. Peace.